So progress to me means that we have a world of abundance. The vision of that world is where we no longer have a billion people that go hungry, where we look after animals. We no longer have to use them for food, right? Wild Earth is a future of pet food company. As humanity grows, as the next 3 billion humans grow, not only is there demand for more resources in terms of food and protein, but we also have a very deep connection with dogs. And so we're going to see hundreds of millions of new dogs come into existence. And the big question is, how are we going to feed them? So in the US, our meat consumption, 30% of our meat consumption is for our pets, 30%. So if the US dogs and cats were their own nation, they would be the fifth largest nation of meat consumers. And so that's just not sustainable, right? If India and China want to have 70% pet ownership, we won't have enough meat on this planet to feed all of those additional pets. And so what I want to do is I want to use biotechnology. We're starting first with fungi, which we can grow from sugar, and we can grow fungi, which is high quality, clean protein. We're using koji. It's in miso soup and soy sauce. It's the fungi that makes that. It's a really nice, clean, savory tasting fungi. And we're going to use that to replace the meat that's normally put into a first dog food and then eventually cat food as well. So the vision is transformative, and so we really want to reinvent the pet food industry across the board. One other aspect to the business that we're building, it's not just the innovation on the biotechnology, but we really want to bring forward cruelty-free food for pets. So this is something a lot of people don't really know, that conventional pet food companies still test their food on lab dogs and cats. Cats and dogs that live their entire lives behind bars, in cages, in labs, that are tested on, and I want to end that. And so that's really my mission for the next couple of years. It's going to be to end that as a standard practice. And this happens all over the world. Europe is a little more advanced in terms of banning these types of testing, but it still happens for most conventional pet food companies.